The Christchurch terror attacks were deeply shocking. And in the devastation that followed, many of us asked just how safe we really are. How could the gunman legally amass an arsenal that could kill so many people? Very quickly, the government banned many of the firearms he used. Now, with the gun buyback underway, gun owners have until December to hand them in. But are we any safer? Here's Mark Kreisel.
On March 15th, New Zealand's biggest gun dealer had a rare moment of doubt. Were you thinking he may have bought a gun from us?
No, I was thinking, I hope he didn't.
51 people shot dead in two Christchurch mosques by a lone gunman armed with an arsenal of military-style semi-automatics.
You did sell a firearm.
We sold him other guns, but not that AR-15.
Do you ever feel that you have blood on your hands when these happen?
I don't.
David Tipple, the face of opposition to the government gun ban, under siege and over it.
You stop lynching me as a gun owner.
What did the family say to you when you said you were going to talk to the media?
Hell no.
But if the hunter is feeling hunted, then he's hiding in plain sight.
So this is your new place, eh?
Yep.
Wow. How many firearms do you have in here?
About 600, I think.
Who buys guns from here?
So people who are looking for hunting deer and tar, wallabies, goats, and target shooters.
5 months after the terror attacks and hardline gun reforms, David Tipple opened his newest gun store in Christchurch.
How do you feel about the fact that you can only now sell a gun that only fires 10 rounds?
You've got 10-shot magazine that feeds in there.
How do I feel? I feel totally ripped off. But what do? Live on feelings like the people who have made these rules, or just live with the facts and get on with it?
He's now got 8 stores nationwide, including what he says is the biggest in the world.
Yeah, there's no other store in the world that has this amount of space dedicated to firearms.
Guns, ammo, and everything that goes with them. 150 staff across the country.
This is IT and online.
It's a business that quite literally booms.
That's your copy, bud.
Thank you very much.
Turnovers in the tens of millions.
You can see I've got a family full of camera-shy people.
Hello.
This is very much a family business.
We've got Matthew is number one, born in 1981. We've got Amy, number two. Tim, Lily.
5 of his 6 children work here.
Not sure whether we should have, but we did. Number 6, Chloe.
There's also the 17 grandchildren.
If it's duck shooting tomorrow morning, everybody's in, you know, ask her. Lucy, would you like to go duck shooting?
Yes, please.
Yeah.
And how old are you?
4.
4.
Ah.
Gunpowder is in the Tipple family's veins.
How good are you?
How good am I? Well, currently I'm 5th in the world. My target's going to come out of here, and you're going to move the bead to the target.
David's youngest, Chloe.
And you're going to close the action. That's it. You're going to put the stock into your shoulder there.
Is a Kiwi Olympian and Commonwealth Games shooter. Nice she grew up doing this. For others,
Paul,
it can be confronting.
Good job, mate.
Do you understand how people can be frightened of guns?
Absolutely. Just like how anybody can be frightened of anything they don't know about.
And Tipples aren't frightened to fire back over the gun reforms.
I feel sad, I feel villainised. I think it's absolutely tragic. I think what we're doing now is we are penalising the law-abiding citizens.
Problem is, outwardly, the accused mosque gunman was also law-abiding. Brenton Tarrant had a firearms licence and legally bought his guns.
Should he have been allowed to amass an arsenal?
Should he have? Absolutely not. Look at the state of his mental state. Should he have had a licence? Absolutely not. Did the police drop the ball, and did we drop the ball with giving that man a licence? Yes, we did. But that's not the gun's fault. Ah! because we, as gun owners and we as license holders, enjoy the sport and like handling guns and like shooting guns, we are now the evil person.
But to Elliot Marshall Dawson, some guns are evil.
When we heard the shooting, it sounded like fireworks.
Elliot was praying at the Linwood Mosque on March 15th when the gunman entered.
I moved back and forth a bit, panicking.
Quickly, he hid in the bathroom.
Thinking, am I going to die? I didn't know what was going to happen.
What he could hear was his friend dying.
The hardest part for me was losing her.
One gunman, two mosques, 20 minutes, 51 people dead.
I don't think there's any need for these type of weapons.
And nor did Parliament.
Mr. Speaker, we are ultimately here because 50 people died and they do not have a voice.
Just 28 days after the shootings, it unanimously voted for a ban on semi-automatic firearms, some shotguns, parts and magazines that carry more than 10 cartridges.
We in this House are their voice. And today, Mr. Speaker, we have used that voice wisely.
What do you think about the haste that this legislation went through?
I think the haste was criminal. Just straight out criminal.
David Tipple argued against the ban in a submission to the Select Committee.
A saving of 41 million.
Which one of us in our wildest dreams thinks that tens of thousands of submissions were read in 2 days? I mean, that is a crock. That didn't happen.
4 months later.
These are the items that we've pulled out that have been prohibited.
Gun City's cache of banned guns are off the shelves and waiting to be collected.
Do you accept, though, that this will work? This will make New Zealand safer if you don't have access to these sorts of weapons?
Absolutely not. That is a joke. Like, to consider that this crazy madman would never have done it without access to a firearm, you have to be loopy.
But if he only had a 22, he wouldn't have killed 51 people.
Well, he wouldn't have used a 22, you see. He would have gone and then used a bomb or like a truck in Nice or a van or whatever. Like, we've got to look at the cause and not the tool they use today.
This is the NRA guns don't kill people, people kill people argument. I mean, it's a stupid argument.
Nick Green is one of the founders of Gun Control NZ.
If it's a semi-automatic weapon, you can kill large numbers of people at very short notice, and it's very difficult and dangerous to stop someone with a gun from killing people. I mean, the notion that guns don't amplify the ability to kill is ridiculous.
The day after the Christchurch terror attacks, Nick Green started an online petition calling for a ban on semi-automatics. 5 days later, 70,000 people had signed.
There is no need for high-powered lethal weapons like semi-automatics in modern New Zealand.
Gun City conducted its own online survey of gun owners.
What are gun owners saying to you, the ones that have to hand their guns in?
93% of them are not handing them in yet, they're waiting.
When we come back...
These are basically the firearms that I'm going to have to surrender.
...on the front line of the gun buybacks.
The alleged Christchurch shooter used one of these?
Correct.
And could New Zealand have acted sooner?
If we had banned those guns after Arimawana, would the Christchurch massacre have happened? What is it you like about these firearms?
I just love shooting. Yeah. I'm a sheet metal worker by trade, and I love the engineering that goes into it. And, you know, when you pull the trigger, it's like someone revving up their V8 engine in their car, you know. They just love that noise and love that feeling they get.
Gene Letford is one of a quarter of a million Kiwis who has a firearms licence.
I've done a lot of hunting with that rifle, but these ones here, great competition guns.
But all the guns on his kitchen table are now banned, about $20,000 worth.
These are basically the firearms that I'm going to have to surrender.
The alleged Christchurch shooter used one of these?
Correct. Yep, almost identical to this.
And that's an AK-47?
Yes.
The AK-47, also known as the Kalashnikov, similar to the gun used by David Gray to kill 13 people at Arimawana in 1990.
How vivid are your memories of the day now?
Oh, still there.
Mike Kine has stared down the barrel of a mass murderer carrying a semi-automatic.
For mass shooters, it's a pure killing machine. It's what it's designed to do, and they're very effective.
Back then, Mike was the head of the anti-terrorist unit hunting down David Gray.
What sort of damage do those guns do to human beings?
The bodies were horrific, Mark, the damage that was done to them. It wasn't a pretty sight. He was an accurate shooter.
They found him hiding out in a batch.
He burst through the front doors, they were French doors, and he burst through those firing at us, and we just had to fire back.
Gun laws were tightened after Aramoana. A special category of license to buy military-style semi-automatics was introduced, but no ban.
Should we have banned those military-style semi-automatics after Aramoana?
I think we should have.
Would the Christchurch massacre have happened?
Well, he wouldn't have been able to buy those firearms in New Zealand.
Gun City's David Tipple sold ammunition to David Gray. 30 years later, the accused Christchurch mosque shooter bought guns off him. Will a ban make us any safer? He says no.
Are guns dangerous?
Yes.
So why should we sell them?
Well, where do you draw the line? It's not about the danger, it's about public safety. At the end of the day, firearms owners are the most law-abiding people in the country, all right? They are stretched and tested and interviewed more than anybody else.
But I'll stop you there. It just takes one, doesn't it?
It does.
They're not all law-abiding.
No.
In fact, there are a number that aren't. And when they have a gun, that makes them even more dangerous.
But you've got to face facts. We are never completely safe. Look at motor vehicles. More deaths than last year. So is it the motor vehicle that's the problem? Do we need to ban that?
But to Nick Green of Gun Control NZ, a ban on semi-automatics is just the start.
The licensing and the vetting system isn't strong enough. So you need to limit access from undesirable people from the systems, you need to control access to the firearms, you need to control access to ammunition, and you need to have proper penalties for misuse.
So far, around 15,000 banned firearms have been handed into police as part of the buyback scheme. Gun owners have until the 20th of December to hand them in.
The gun buyback is taking place up there today at the old racecourse. Are you going to be taking yours in?
No, not today.
Why not?
I'm still holding out hope that the government will repeal at least for sporting shooters and people who have demonstrated that they're safe, that we can keep having our guns and keep competing in our sport.
What nobody can say for sure is how many are still out there. It's likely to be many times more.
I would say most people will hold on till the deadline.
When this deadline comes and you haven't been able to overturn the legislation, will you still hand in your guns?
Absolutely.
Do you think everyone's going to do that?
No.
Does that concern you?
Absolutely.
Watch it, boss.
David Tipple is a clean-living Christian family man, but he's had his brushes with the law. Police pursuits, a jail term in the US, for gun offences.
You don't like authority, really, do
well,
you?
Well, no, I have a difficulty. I look at authority with a view, is it fair?
Despite that, when the time comes to hand over his banned firearms, he will toe the line.
Will you get in behind this legislation?
I have to. This bed has been made for us and we must sleep in it, and who knows what the future holds, but right now, the now, is we've got to do this.
Would you ban all guns?
No, no. I mean, hunting and shooting are an important part of life for many New Zealanders. No one wants to take that away. The issue is striking the balance.
Remember Elliot Marshall Dawson, a survivor of the mosque terror attacks?
For a long time, I was just feeling like empty inside. And
he heard the gunman shoot down his friends with a semi-automatic.
What do you say to those gun owners who just don't want to let go of them, that want to hold on to them?
Well, they should be thinking about people's safety, not just Muslim safety, it's about people in general. But these type of guns are just give people access to mass murder rather than just a few dead.
Meanwhile, the Council of Licensed Firearms Owners is not giving up its fight to overturn some of the government's gun reforms. They say the crowdfunding campaign has almost raised enough money to cover the costs of legal action over the reforms.